Adrian, you've got to tell us about where this wacky idea that we built the song came from, man.
One of my favorite things is watching Josh suffer. And it's out of a fear of his capabilities. In a lot of ways, I like to think of him as an apprentice.
He's your drum apprentice, is he?
This was just one of those things where I was just experimenting with a different instrument. Sometimes, I'm sure guitarists understand, the guitar feels so limiting in some of those moments. And just conceptually, we always have a little bit of a giggle about shuffles and the possibilities of a shuffle and how freaking good Josh is at shuffles. So you're just sitting there at night and you're just going, oh, I wonder if that happens. I wonder what happens when you do that. I couldn't really conceptualize it. So I kind of just put something in. I think I did it in Guitar Pro for some reason, and I just
so you gave me a thing. It basically went do 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 do, and I remember you were kind of down on yourself for it because you didn't really see kind of what we could do with it. And I remember just hearing me like, "Yes, this is going to be a shuffle now."
That's the mandate of the band: is what can we turn into a shuffle?
How can Sam make my ideas to the point where I can't conceive how on earth that happened? Because that's what it was: getting that first demo back, being like, "Are you sure? How did I even?"
And I reckon that was 2 hours from when you sent it to me, because I got it and I was just like, "Man, this is awesome! This is cool. Let me put something together. Let me show you what I reckon." And it worked so well. I loved it. But yeah, I mean, in terms of like putting the actual music for that one together, like obviously a lot of it was built out of that quintuplet idea, that idea that we were going to have this kind of simple rhythmic motif that was in quintuplets and we were going to milk it for all that it's worth. We're going to play all these different chords over it, play it as heavy, play it as a light pattern, experiment with its density throughout. But as we started building that song, and I think that was one, Jim, that you and I started working on very early in the musical development. I remember we had, I think, the intro and the verse maybe, and it was from there that we started toying with the other ideas. It became pretty obvious that it had this potential breadth to it that was much greater than some of the shorter songs on the album. And as we started working on it, it ended up being this vessel for a lot of stranger ideas that we'd had, like the blast beat in the intro and like that big kind of Pagliacci-esque kind of like opera outro that we were playing with. Mm. It's a pretty bizarre piece of music on paper, but I go on a limb and say it's probably my favorite song on the record, I think. I like a lot of these songs. They're my children, etc. but really, it really just came together in a way that I couldn't have imagined, I think, when we first started playing with those disparate and very strange ideas. But why don't you tell us what the lyrics and stuff are about?
It's another example of saying exactly directly what I was feeling, you know what I mean? Rather than, again, sort of feeling a particular emotion and sort of putting it through someone else's lens, it was very much like, okay, I'm in a very bad place, you know, struggling with a whole bunch of different mental health issues. And, you know, I've gone through periods of being suicidal in my life, and this was one of the particularly bad ones. And I remember sitting there and kind of going through a moment of just like, well, let's use this, you know, let's not just sit there and wallow in it. Let's find a use for it. And I sat down on the edge of the bed at like 3 a.m. with my phone and just started throwing together different lines and different ways to express sort of what it was that I was going through, but not in kind of like a maudlin poor me kind of way. Just like, how do I describe this sensation to someone that hasn't experienced it before? And a lot of that sort of formed the foundation for the verses throughout it. And then just like everything else that we do that has a darker touch, I very much didn't want to sort of celebrate the hole that I was in. I wanted to celebrate the way out. And so that journey of the song was finding a way to take these themes and things that had come out of a very dark place and sort of portray them in a way that makes people who are listening to it kind of see that there is a way out from that, that it isn't kind of like an ultimate situation to be in that. So yeah, I love it too. I think it's a very personal one for me.
I mean, it just occurred to me as you were kind of explaining that, because of course it is this very personal lyric. If there is a song that really is directly about that getting back up concept, surely it's Salt. Mm. Like, even if it doesn't end particularly triumphantly in that respect, it still has that kind of, you know, you are down, but you still have value and you're going to do your best to kind of push against what it is that you are being put through, whether it's mental or whether it's, you know, whether it's internal or external, I suppose. Mm. But I remember just loving those themes as they came together. The one part that I remember just as a standout was the crazy kind of unison part in the middle. You remember the 12-8? I know all the words. That whole section. I remember writing that as this instrumental part and thinking it was great. I really loved it. It was a cool play on the intro theme. And I remember you being like, yeah, but what about if I sung it? It's like, that's like, not a vocal line, Jim. That's silly.
What if I decided to have a hard time putting this together for a few days? I love that bit as well, because it takes it in a direction that we would not normally go. It's not really an approach that we've sort of had taken in the past. But it sort of opened out the journey into like a almost like a different voice entering the conversation there, almost like a moment of sort of realization. So you're less kind of the victim of this intrusive thought, more just sort of observing it. And I think that's the transition that point in the song takes there. Necessary for vocals, Sam.
That's true. Belting for 7 minutes seems good in theory.